Okay, this problem asks us to find lateral surface area and total surface area. I'm going to do lateral surface area in this video, and then I'll do the total surface area in part two of this, okay? I'm going to write the steps out to the side just so you can follow along and see where I am. And the first step would be to write the formula. So lateral surface area is 1/2 PL, and the P is perimeter of the base. And the L is called slant height. Okay, hold on, my pen is having issues. Okay, so I'm sorry for keep interrupting, but my pen isn't working right. But the slant height is L, and so we have to talk for a minute about what slant height actually means. And I have a picture here of a pyramid. And so there's two heights on a pyramid. This one right here, if you can see that, oops, is the slant height on the outside. Oops. And this one on the inside is the regular height. Okay, so the slant height is like if you were going to walk up along the outside of the pyramid, like you're the priest about to do some ritual. And the regular height, the inside one, is like if you were the pharaoh and you were buried, that's where you would be going up and down inside of the pyramid. Okay, so if you can see in our example, they give us the regular height on the inside. So this is where the pharaoh is going up and down cursing the pyramid. We need to figure out what the slant height is. They don't give that to us. So I'm going to write that on our list of things to do. Figure out the slant height. Okay. So to figure out the slant height, I'm going to show you another picture. Maybe. Okay. And it's right here. I didn't mean for that to appear there. Hold on. Okay, so here's my picture, and it's just to show you. But as you can see, we've got a right triangle here, right there. And remember, this slant height there is where the pharaoh is walking up the side of the pyramid, or I'm sorry, the priest, and then this inside height is where the pharaoh is going up and down. So we're going to use, in order to solve for the slant height, we're going to use your favorite, which is Pythagorean Theorem. So I'm actually, okay, 15 is our height, and 16 is all the way across, so that means that halfway across would be 8. Okay, and let's add this to our list here. Use Pythagorean Theorem. Okay, so use Pythagorean Theorem. Okay, so I'm going to go back down here to my other picture. So this here is 8 because the whole distance was 16, and this one here is 15. So we have 15 squared plus 8 squared equals something squared, and then I'm going to do 15 squared is 225, 8 squared is 64, and if we add those, we get 9, 8, 2. And then remember, your last step of the Pythagorean Theorem is always to take the square root. So the square root of 289 is 17. So that means that our priest would have to walk 17 feet along the outside of the pyramid. So we go back up and put that number in here. That's 17 is our slant height. Okay, so now we just plug everything into our formula right up here, and I'm going to actually do it down here. 1/2, the perimeter is the guards walking around the outside of our pyramid. So it's 16 plus 16 plus 16 plus 16, which is 64. And the slant height we already figured out is 17. So we're going to plug all that in the calculator. And you get 544, which is the answer. Okay?